Hey guys, it's Quad Nation, back to you with another video. So today we'll be going over the 2-year, 100-hour review of this 2018 Yamaha Raptor 700R SE. So let me go ahead and get something out of the way real quick. If you're familiar with me, or you know my channel, you know my style of riding. However, if you're not familiar with me, when I say there's 100 hard hours on this quad, there are truly 100 hard hours on this quad. If I'm on this quad, odds are I have that throttle pegged 100% wide open throttle. Do I abuse the quad? No. I mean, I take care of it. It looks like, in fact, it looks like it just come off the showroom floor. But I ride it hard, guys. I ride it hard. I race it hard. If I'm on it, I'm probably racing. Or I'm racing myself. I don't know at this point. But I ride this thing hard, guys, but I take care of it at the same time. I took it to Yamaha at 20 hours. They checked the valves. Valves were in spec. They flushed the fluid. Not sure why they flushed the coolant at 20 hours, but they did because it used to be red. Now it's green. They said the valves were in spec, and off I went for another 80 hours, and here we are today at 100 hours, okay? It is going to get checked again at 120 hours. I got 20 more hours to ride it. And I'm gonna ride it like I stole it. I'm riding it, I'm racing it, I'm riding it hard. But this video, I wanna stress to you guys, it's got truly 100 hard hours on it. So this is a great 2-year, 100-hour review. So let's start from the bottom up, okay? Tires. Tires have been exposed to blacktop, lime rock, sand, and mud, okay? The back tires, they're wore out pretty badly, okay? There's about maybe 10% tread left on them, okay? They're always spinning, okay? I do not do burnouts on the blacktop, but they're always spinning on everything else, okay? I'm always going wide open throttle to the last minute where I gotta slam on the brakes or I'm hit trees. That means the brakes and tires are always stopping fast. With that being said, the tires have held up great up front. They still have about 75% tread, okay? The brakes, I recently looked at them, over 50% left on the pads. The back brakes, about 75%. You can see that here. Right there, 75% of the pads are still left. The chain, 100 hours on this chain and sprockets. You guys will not believe me. You're probably gonna say I'm lying, but I've tightened that chain one time. One time, and it was at 85 hours. So since I've tightened it, I've put another 15 hours on it. And it's still right in spec. Now you're probably wondering, how in the hell did I do that? Well, before every ride, I lube the chain. And I don't just, you know, half you know what, spray the sprocket. I lube the entire chain, okay? I went 85 hours before I had to tighten it. And I didn't let it go loose forever, whatever. Just when I got to the point where I thought it needed to be tightened, I tightened it. Guys, the sprocket teeth are still in awesome condition. This is not just a street legal, like, you know, ride it on pavement, you know, where not much dirt or grime gets in the sprockets wearing them out. No, I've had this buried in mud. It's Florida sand tears up everything. This chain and sprockets have held up awesome, guys. What that tells me is Yamaha did not shortchange us there. They put some good stuff on this quad. Coming further up, the engine. I haven't had it dynoed yet. I am going to do another compression test soon. You guys know that it was on the very upper end of the compression test in earlier videos, so it was a very strong motor. I'm going to do a compression test again, see if I've lost any power at 100 hours now, but it doesn't feel like I've lost any. This thing still feels like it's freaking F-22 fighter jet, okay? It's freaking insane how much power this thing has. I don't know when I'm going to have to rebuild it. Some folks have rebuilt theirs at 100 hours. This one's still kicking strong. I bet you I'll be able to get a gazillion hours out of it. All right, absolutely love the motor. Very reliable. As far as stability, is this a top-heavy quad? Well, it's top-heavy compared to a 450. But let's be real, guys. It's really not all that top-heavy. However, so that way I can compete with my buddies that I ride with the 450s and be a little bit more stable because we're going to start track riding soon. We're going to be building a track, so stay tuned for that. I did go ahead and recently buy Alba Racing A-arms 2 inches wider on each side, so a total of 4. I am going to use my stock shocks. All right, So I got those. I'll be putting them on soon, so look out for that video. Also went with 2-inch wheel spacers on each side for this, so it'll pop it out 4 inches total. So be looking out for that video, guys. That's going to give me tons of stability. Also, something else, as soon as these tires wear out, I'm sticking with these. I'm beating everybody with these stock tires, even bald like this. I truly believe the low profile small tires give me that extra torque compared to someone with a huge tire that they got to turn over. But I'm going to go with the YFZ450 tires because they're about 3/4 inches wider on each side. It gives you 1.5 inches per tire. It's because they have the same rim and tire, really, but their sidewall goes straight up and is like boxy compared to being curved in here. So doing that, 1.5 inches per tire, that'll give me 3 inches of extra rubber for the entire axle if I go with the YFZ450 tires. And I love that low profile look. So that's the tire I'm going to be going with, or the 450 tires. That'll be later on this year. Headlights. This is probably my biggest, this and the governor. I'll talk about the governor in a second. But the headlights are absolute garbage on this quad, guys. You spend $10,000 and you buy cream of the crop, the king of the big bore quads. This is the Yamaha Raptor. It is the elite, and they give me garbage headlights. Why? 20 hours after I had the quad, I was following my buddy CRF450. He was shooting rooster tails. I was traveling behind him about 70 miles an hour, and he essentially sandblasted my headlights. Complete garbage, guys. They're shot. They're completely, they look foggy. They're not clear at all. They look ugly. I don't expect Yamaha to put glass in them, but they need to do something different, a better plastic. So it's 80 per side, so I'm going to be spending 160 on headlights eventually soon again to get that crisp, clean look. So, and it was after they were damaged that I found a guy who makes the lens covers for them. So that's something that Yamaha should offer, because I had asked them when I bought the quad if there are covers for the lights, and they said no. Unfortunately, I found that out after I found some after they were damaged. So completely bad there on their part. They should have better plastic in the headlights. As far as the governor, this is my biggest complaint about the Yamaha Raptor. When I bought this quad, I expected it to be like race ready, essentially. I understand it's not the 450 racing quad, but it's still the king of the big bores. And this thing comes from factory governed at 6,400 RPMs. That's terrible, guys. What that means is I can pretty much go just as fast in fourth gear by revving it to 9,000 RPMs as I can in fifth gear, purring along at 6,400 RPMs. And I knew something was wrong, because as I was drag racing, as soon as I'd hit fifth gear, I'd feel it pull for just a second, and it's like, bam, I'd hit a brick wall, and it would just purr along. And I could tell the RPMs weren't continuing to build. So I knew there was a governor on it. I just didn't know at what RPM. I did some research and discovered it's governed at 6,400 RPMs from factory with stock ECU. How do you eliminate that? Well, you got to buy a fuel modular power programmer. Well, just as it would be, in order to get a full system exhaust, it requires a power programmer. So eventually I won't have to worry about the governor, because when I do go with the full system exhaust, I'll be going with the fuel controller. That'll eliminate that governor. And I'm going to go with an intake as well. Comment down below which exhaust you guys would go with. I'm looking at 3 different ones: Empire, Industries, Rozier Engineering, and Monster. Let me know which one you would go with. As far as the components, the handlebars and everything, I've had no problems. Nothing has gotten stiff. I love everything about it. My hand grips have wore out a little bit, but that's 100 hours of trying to hold on for dear life. So that's expected. And the plastics in the seat are holding up well to the sun's rays, okay? Sorry about that, but my battery had died. But anyways, right back to what I was saying, the seat has held up well, so have the fenders, all the decals, nothing has faded, none of the rubber components, none of the brake lines, throttle lines, or anything like that. Everything looks as if it did from day one. It is garage kept. However, you know, a lot of times I have it out in the sun between riding and hauling at places. So the sun, it has seen its fair share of sun, but it's held up well. One other thing I thought of while I was swapping out the batteries, I meant to mention when I was talking about the motor, is the exhaust. There's no rust on my exhaust, guys. There's a couple little, like there's a little spot right here. Not sure if you can even see it. Oh, I'm melting my glove too. I had to take the quad back to my house to get the battery. But anyways, there's a little spot right there. Other than that, the black paint has held up well on this exhaust, guys. The header pipe obviously did not come in black, but if you look at it as well, you'll see a lot of folks, theirs is rusted out in no time, Raptor or not. Mine has just a little bit of pitting right there. Other than that, look at that, guys. It's in great shape. Not sure if you can really tell, but there we go. It's in great shape. One of the things I do is, in my opinion, the rain is the worst element for your exhaust. So if I ever get caught up in rain, when I get home, I'm always sure to spray off my quad, because the water coming out of the well doesn't have all the contaminants in it as the rain does. So my theory, I think, whether it works or not, my exhaust has held up a lot better than a lot of other guys that I ride with. In fact, one of my buddies that has a blue Raptor, his exhaust was completely rusted out. Like, I mean, I'm talking rust. Like, the entire thing was nothing but a big chunk of rust. And it was rusted out like that after 1 year. So maybe there's something to be said about me spraying off the rainwater or any of the mud water that had dried on it. So that's what I've done. My exhaust has little to no rust on it. So that was the last thing I wanted to touch base on the engine. I've pretty much went over everything good and bad on this quad. So that's pretty much it. That is the 2 year, 100 hour review. I'm satisfied, guys. I give this quad a 10 out of 10. As far as engine and performance, 10, okay? Stability, I give it a 8 out of 10. As far as the headlights, I give it a 1 out of 10. But anyhow, that's pretty much it, guys. This is the 100 hour review. If you're new to the channel, please help support me by subscribing if you like this kind of stuff. And to my Quad Nation family, I love each and every one of you. You guys are awesome. Thank you for motivating me along the way. I love it when you guys interact by commenting. It's awesome. There's definitely a decent group of you guys that interact with me on a regular basis, and I absolutely freaking love it, guys. You guys are family. Hopefully, I can end up going out and riding with you guys eventually. Those of you who have watched this, and I may have missed something, maybe you wanted to ask about the throttle body, or I don't know, the clutch plates or not, which the clutch is not giving me any problems, but whatever it may be, bearing, stuff like that, if there's something I didn't go over and you're curious about, since it has 100 hours, hit me up in the comments down below. I usually respond same day. If I don't, shoot me another one saying, hey, you know, you may have looked over my comment, because I recently did that to one of my buddies and I feel pretty bad. So definitely shoot me a comment down below, whatever I may have missed during this review. But I wanted to be I am a diehard Raptor fan, but this is a non-biased review. I hope you guys can trust and believe me when I say that. I really truly gave you the good and the bad. The best thing of all, it's undefeated. Not on top end, because that stupid freaking governor, but it truly is undefeated in the whole shot mid-range. Big D, Hitman, you guys know this. But anyhow, I won't go on to that. I won't go down that road. But anyhow, guys, this is Quad Nation 929. I'm out.